Shalom and welcome to another edition of Kosher Caffeine, turbocharging your soul right now and right here. Today I'd like to talk to you about Kabbalah and physics. What does Kabbalah and physics have with each other? Well, the answer is Kabbalah is the science that is the energy, the source, and the root behind everything that manifests itself in this world. When you're looking at the world, you are looking at the peak of what's behind all of that, and that's the science of Kabbalah. When you study Kabbalah, you are connected with the root and the source, the well, which gives forth the possibility of everything you find in this universe. In the same way that the knowledge of electricity will bring you no good unless electricity is channeled through wires and switches, the same way also with the study of Kabbalah, it will only bring you benefit if it's channeled through the wires and switches of holiness and spirituality, and that's the observance of God's commandments. The observance of God's commandments to literally light the Shabbat candles or take the coin and put in the charity box, that's what will create the reverberation of kindness, the aura of blessing around you. It's the switch that brings the electricity. It's the mitzvah that gets connected to the signs and the blessings of Kabbalah. Now, a little bit of Kabbalah and physics. In physics, there's a rule that states, if electricity is flowing in the direction of my thumb, the magnetic field around this wire is going to go in a counterclockwise direction. If the electricity is going this way, downwards, can you see me? Then it's going to be going in this direction. Let me get it out of my face. Now, where are we getting with all of this? How does the flow of electricity and the magnetic field that it causes have anything to do with Kabbalah and the switch of God's observance and mitzvot? Well, in the Talmud there is a statement that any time we turn, we should always turn to the right side, because the right has a very great big emphasis in the Torah and in the understanding of Kabbalah. But the question is, when it says you should turn to the right, how exactly should you turn to the right? Do you go to your right hand first, but then it's your left shoulder that's moving first? Or should you move your right side first, but then you're going to your left side? Well, the rabbis, they came up with a compromise. But when it comes to the study of Torah, we say that turning to the right means actually turning to our right side, even though it's the left shoulder that moves first. When it comes to prayer, we should move our right shoulder first, even though it means we are going to our left side. So, for example, when it comes to prayer Friday night, and we need to make a turn around in the Lechun Aranina, how do we turn? We turn towards our left, using our right shoulder first. Remember what we said? We said that if the current is going upwards, then we turn with our right shoulder first, counterclockwise towards our left side. Now, when we are praying, our sages tell us, we are working on ourselves and elevating our lives to godliness. The current is going up. When we are studying the Torah, we are drawing the infinite knowledge and wisdom of God like a student. We are bringing it down to ourselves. So when we are praying, we are working on elevating, going upwards. When we are studying the Torah, we are receiving the infinite godly wisdom from up down here to this world. And that is why the sages, in their infinite Kabbalistic wisdom, decided that the compromise should be in the following way. That when it comes to prayer, and it's all about going up, remember? It's all about the energy going up. It turns in the direction of counterclockwise. Therefore, we turn with our right shoulder first, going to the left. But when it comes to lifting the Torah in the synagogue, so everybody can get connected to the reading of the Torah, which is God's revelation from above down, we lift the Torah and we turn to our right side with our left shoulder moving first. And you thought all these practices were childish and insignificant, but now you know that the movement that we make while we're in shul, praying and connected to the Torah, is the actual magnetic field that we are creating, a reality that we are making around us. No joke when you do a mitzvah. It's no joke when you understand and appreciate the effects of those mitzvahs, of picking up and down the switch through the study of Kabbalah. So do an extra mitzvah today, and do it just as the rabbis prescribed it, and you will be making the magnetic field around you, the aura, to be one of blessings and of infinite goodness. It will be the source, it will be the underlying energy. When you do those switches of mitzvot, of God's commandments, that will manifest and express itself in great blessings in your life.